Next important operating system is distributed operating system. Basically, this operating system is needed when we want to share the data among multiple users. See, it's not the matter of lot of work has to be done. Please take note of that. It's not like that ki I'm distributing the data on the various location because of chunk on one system. No, not like that. Data must be shared to the multiple users. That's why this type of operating system has came into picture, right? So let's take some few points on distributed operating system, then I will explain you with the help of neat and clean diagram. So what is the first point? As I have already told you, data has to be shared. Means we want that data should be shared. Now the second point, how it will be shared? So data will be shared by storing and processing it on multiple computers, right? Correct? Okay, fine. Now these computers are stored at different location, right? If the data is being shared or data is being stored and processed on multiple computers, and if you want that data sometimes or somehow, then these multiple computers must be located at different position, right? Okay, fine. Position or location. Next one is these computers are interconnected through computer network. Why is it so? Because now not only we want that data is stored and processed at different location, but if at any time if you want the data to be retrieved back to any site or to any location, we can able to retrieve that data. And how we will able to retrieve that data? If these multiple computers which are located at different locations will be interconnected with computer networks. So it is very, very mandatory that these multiple computers which are already established or located at various locations must be interconnected through some computer network, right? Next one is your data are made shareable for multiple users, right? Data must be shareable for multiple users. Just take example of Indian railway reservation site, right? So suppose I'm taking one example. Suppose I want to book one ticket in Rajdhani Express. So in that train, not only I who wish to take a ticket in Rajdhani Express, so many users are also willing to take the reservation ticket in that particular Rajdhani on particular date on which I want. So that means what? The availability of the Rajdhani Express, availability of the seat of the Rajdhani Express will be treated as data and it will be shareable to all, right? It will be shareable to all. Whosoever wants to take the reservation in that Rajdhani Express on that particular date, he can take it according to the availability of seats. That means the availability of seats of that particular train is giving the information to all. That is why here it has been included or concluded that data are made shareable to the multiple users, right? Next, but the main thing is that, okay, accessing of data must be authorized. See, we are sharing the data to the multiple users, but we have to also take this into consideration that the person who is accessing the data must be authorized, right? The data should not be given to the unauthorized user. Checkpoint or that condition or that condition must be taken care of distributed operating system. So according to the previous discussion, let's have a quick look on this diagram. In this diagram, basically we are having four computers. Computer 1, this is also computer 2. In short, I have written comp. This is computer 3 and this is computer 4. So mainly four computers are interconnected with each other. Here we are not bothering about which network topology we have used for interconnection, but all these systems are connected, right? And the major part is that ki all of the systems are having some operating system, right? Okay, fine. Now see, in computer 2 and computer 3, we are having CPU, we are having memory, and we are having hard disk. That means each system can have its own hard disk or not, right? But each and every system must have its own CPU and memory. See, watch carefully that all the four systems is having CPU and its own local memory, right? Okay. Out of these four systems, two of them are having hard disk and other two are not having hard disk. So, if the system is not having hard disk, they will be directly connected to the server, right? Which is also known as in computing, right? In means real scenario, it is also known as in computing. Basically, we want to reduce the cost of hard disk. That is why instead of hard disk, just we will connect those machines to the main server, right? And sometimes we will also provide the hard disks to different systems. Okay, fine. So this is the good picture of your distributed operating system. Now, this operating system may be similar for all the system. That means identical, not similar, identical. If this operating system is identical, means same for all system, such type of distributed operating system will be known as homogeneous distributed operating system. Why it is known as homogeneous? Because all the systems are having the same operating system. But if the operating system varies, then that type of distributed operating system will be called as heterogeneous distributed operating system. So after explaining this, after learning this diagram, let's take a quick review on advantages and disadvantages of distributed operating system. So let's have a quick look on advantages and disadvantages of this operating system. First of all, I will just discuss about advantages, and later on I will focus on disadvantages. So just start from this. See, the first one is that failure of one system will not affect the other system. That is the very important point, right? Suppose so many computers are interconnected with each other, or unme se agar ek agar system agar kaam nahi bhi kar raha hai, then it does not mean ki all the system will get dumb, right? This is the best point we have observed in distributed operating system. Next, email increase the speed of the data exchange. Email means what? Electronic mail. So due to this distributed operating system, email has the capability to speed up the exchange of data. Okay, fine. Third point is very, very important. See, due to the resource sharing, the performance of the system has highly upgraded. See, it's not like that ki only the CPU, the speed of the processor will be too high, the performance will be too high. No, not this. The performance of the system is not only depending upon the speed of the processor, but if there is a good resource sharing. Good resource sharing means what? There should be no conflict between resources, right? So if the resource sharing will be good, then ultimately the entire performance of the system will be highly upgraded, right? Next, very important point, load on server will be reduced. What does it mean? Say for example, as we know that when we are talking about all the banks, their head offices are mainly in Mumbai. But what is going to happen? Suppose a person or some few users of a particular state, say for Bihar, they want to transact their account, they want to make the transaction in their bank, let's say suppose PNB. So this type of operating system is providing the privilege that the entire data should not be stored in the headquarters of Mumbai, it should be distributed to various location. इस तरीके से some data are also kept in the local site in various places in Bihar, so that the data should be stored there, they can be processed there, and ultimately a final result may or may not be submitted to the headquarter. Lastly, all the data should be submitted to the headquarter only, but the system should not, means if the processing has to be done in Bihar, so the data will be distributed to Bihar. Let the data should be stored there, let the all the processing will be done on the local side, all the transaction will be done at the local side, and finally last submission can be done at the end of the day. So the load of server will be drastically reduced, right? One more thing is very important, that whatever the delay was occurring earlier, the delay has decreased in data processing. So whenever we are processing the data in distributed operating system, earlier it may so happen that some delay may occurs, but while using the distributed operating system, such type of cases has been drastically dropped down. So let's talk about disadvantages of distributed operating system. So first one is, your if host or server gets failed, the entire network will get failed. In the advantage I have told that if one machine will get failed, there is no problem on other machine. But disadvantage is that if the server, then the entire communication or entire network will fail, means none of the system will execute properly. So this is the bigger disadvantage. Okay, fine. Establishment of distributed operating system is still very complex. Why it is complex? Because the language has not yet well defined, right? Due to the less understanding of or less awareness of this particular language through which this distributed operating system will be designed, it is becoming more complex, right? Next, it is too expensive. Why it is too expensive? Because whenever we are establishing a distributed operating system, naturally we have to go for some network topology. And as we will go for network topology, then the establishment of this type of operating system as compared to earlier one will get costlier, right? That is why this type of operating system is very expensive. And due to expensive also, it is not readily available. See, very few companies are going for such type of operating system. Very few. If it is deeply needed, then only we are going for such type of operating system. Otherwise, in practical or in real scenario, I told you that this type of operating system is not readily available. And one more thing, I have forgot to introduce you, the software which we are using in this OS, in this distributed OS is complex. Why complex? Because the language is complex. Why complex? Because the language is yet not well understood or well defined. That's why the internal software of this type of operating system is very complex to understand.